Hello everyone, starting with the analysis of today's newspaper, that is December 13, 2017. Firstly, it's an article titled Human Rights and Indian Values. The incidents at Dadri, Alwar and Rajsamand wherein a Muslim from the poorest sections were murdered for the identity assigned to them. The problem gets compounded when the government says that it is just a criminal act and is in no way religiously motivated. Now in doing so, the government is rejecting the basic human rights to the citizens, says the article. The article says that neither civilizational ethos nor mere enshrining of constitutional morality is enough to deliver on basic rights. Now this is in reference to Mr. Venkaiah Naidu's speech at Delhi Vigyan Bhavan. He observed that human rights existed not due to some constitutional morality in India, but because of the DNA of Indian civilization. The article says that Indian civilizational values based on caste and exclusiveness do not provide sufficient ground to deliver the basic human rights. Constitutional morality, a term used by Ambedkar, does provide a useful guide to courts, but in itself it is helpless in preventing acts of communalism or any other acts of violence. The efficacy depends on the implementation of these provisions by the government. Placing it in the syllabus, it can be placed in paper 1, Indian society, topic very specifically communalism. Paper 2, Indian polity and governance, specific topic secularism. Dimensions under it. Dimension 1, communalism, history and recent times. Dimension 2, communalism, role of law, constitution, society and government. Moving to the next issue of the day, it is an article titled Information at the Court's Discretion. The article is on the increasing opacity of the judiciary and its brazen disregard for RTI. A former school teacher, R.S. Mishra, had filed an RTI request with the Supreme Court registry. He was asked to apply under Supreme Court rules framed in 1966, to which minor changes were made in 2014. Mr. Mishra challenged this response before Central Information Commissioner Shailesh Gandhi. In May 2011, appearing before Mr. Gandhi, the additional register of the court said that she objected only to the use of RTI and not to Mr. Mishra's request in itself. Then Mr. Gandhi, the Central Information Commissioner, noted that Supreme Court rules undermine RTI Act in four key ways. Unlike RTI, rules of Supreme Court do not provide a time frame for furnishing information. There is no appeal mechanism and penalties for delays or wrongful refusal of information under the Supreme Court rules. The rules also say that information will be disclosed only if there is a good reason given for it. So consequently, Mr. Gandhi held that Supreme Court rules are inconsistent with the RTI Act and that the registry must respond to the application within RTI framework alone. Now, faced with the adverse order, the registry filed a writ petition before Delhi High Court in 2011. Delhi High Court overturns the order and it says that Supreme Court rules are consistent with RTI. Now the article's take on the entire issue is what? The article says why there was a need to apply under Supreme Court rules when Supreme Court rules are consistent with RTI in the first place. And also Section 23 of the RTI Act categorically forbids courts from entertaining any suit on or application under the RTI Act. So in total, the opacity in judiciary and its brazen attempts to disregard RTI questions the credibility of judiciary, says the article. Placing it in the syllabus, it can be placed in paper 2, Indian polity and governance. Under that, specific topic, judiciary. Dimension 1, judiciary and RTI. Dimension 2, question of transparency in judiciary in general. Moving on to the next issue, it is a news item titled Special Courts to Try Politicians. The Centre on Tuesday informed the Supreme Court that it will set up at least 12 special courts to try exclusively criminal cases involving MPs and MLAs. The government in an affidavit said it had allotted rupees 7.8 crore and framed a scheme to set up special courts. The affidavit was in response to a Supreme Court direction in November to the government to set up special courts across the country exclusively to try criminal cases involving political persons. The court is hearing a PIL petition filed by Supreme Court advocate Ashwini Upadhyay, who has sought a lifetime ban on all convicted politicians. In short, it is an attempt by the court to clean politics. It is an attempt by the judiciary to avoid or to clean criminalization of politics. Placing it in syllabus, it can be placed in paper 2, Indian Polity and Governance, very specifically electoral reforms. Now, creating dimensions out of it, dimension 1. Electoral reforms and the role of judiciary in it. What has been the role of judiciary traditionally? So what are the steps judiciary has taken for cleaning the process of elections? Dimension 2. Criminalization of politics, concept and various reforms undertaken till date. That's all for today. Please research on the dimensions. Thank you. Have a nice day.